So it's a very nice Sunday right now. It's the 6th of February and we are now on the old firing range of the fliegerhorst Twente. Currently it's being restored more or less to its original condition. And so as you can see, the fence is already breached. There's my car. I just walked around the fence. This is a bit what it looked like. And here in the front is the actual structure. Also, I made a few improvements to the selfie stick. I've removed that little bit that made a lot of noise. And another piece I have taped off. So it should now become a really good recording in terms of audio quality. What they're also doing here is sort of removing some trees. This bit was really overgrown. There was a lot of vegetation, rather dense, and the actual structure, as you can see there, was really obscured from view. You couldn't almost see it anymore. But now they have sort of brought it back from view. And also they are about to restore this, because this particular area here is going to be sort of a nature zone. They're going to make a walking trail here. And well, what I've heard is that they are going to cut a hole in the roof of that bunker there, which is the well, I don't know really how to call that, but that's what they were shooting in. They would line up a plane in front of this, and they would use that to calibrate the machine gun from the plane, and the bullets would end up in that bit of sand that's in the back of the opening. As you can see, it's quite a massive masonry structure with some sand walls around it. And well, there's a bit of stairs, as I can see, and that's also sort of how it originally was. And right there, where the excavator is, you can still see the old fence work. They've already made a bit of an opening at the back of the structure, because that's where the trail is going to be. That's going to reach inside the forest, because right behind the fence is a trail in the woods that you were always able to access. So this is not the only structure here, there's more. There's also a firing range that was built at the in the Cold War period, in the 1950s. But this structure here is something that was built by the Germans in World War II. As you can see, it's rather muddy, and there is a hole in the fence. And this is where they're going to make a new pathway, and it will connect up there to the path that's in the woods. So I don't know if this mud is stable to walk on. I don't think it is really, and it's it looks rather wet. So we're going to go on top here. We're using the steps that they've just created. These are presumably new, but originally they would have had something very similar to this. And as you can see, it is a really massive structure. There's a bit of sand in there, and the inside is clad with timber. But what I've heard is that they are going to close this up with a metal gate. And well, they may restore a bit of the masonry perhaps. At least that's what I've read. That was a recommendation, that well, the joinery on the bricks could need a little bit of restoration, and this timber here is also original. So, as you can see, this thing is really massive. And that's a big concrete slab. That's about 30 centimeters. And there you can see in the distance is my car. Well, it's not my car, but it's my dad's car. So, here we are on top of the structure. On top of a concrete slab. And normally, you could have only seen the backside of this structure when you're there on the trail, because that's the trail of the forest, where there's many more old relics and structures to be found. But yeah, this is the back side of it. And this thing is massive. Just a big masonry wall with a concrete slab. And over there is supposedly a structure that was built in the Cold War period, and that is rather similar, although smaller. I've seen photos of this. This is the first time that I'm walking here. So, but yeah, this is rather interesting. But I don't think I'll go inside, because I don't know if the mud is like quicksand. And I also don't want my shoes to become extremely dirty. So, let's have a look around. Maybe when the work is completed, they may pave this up a little bit, and then you could get a little closer. Anyway, I think it's time for a photo. Okay, I've made some photos. Now we proceed, and we're going right over there to the right to check out what we can find there. So, and whilst I'm walking down, I'll spin the camera a little bit so that you can have a bit of a look. So that's the the big firing pit. I don't know what the English name for that is, but let's proceed. Oh, it is a bit slippery here, but that's... Oh shit, I stepped into the mud. Right there. That's my footprint. It's really muddy. And this is why I don't want to go inside yet, because, you just don't know how far you end up in the mud. So that is the excavator. It's a CAT. That's a well-known brand of excavators. Now we're going to check this out. Here you can see a lot of trenches. These trenches are an original feature of this woods. It has something to do with the water management. Originally in the 19th century, this woods was just a field with heather. It didn't have trees. They were planted here by an industrialist, and they were planted in the late 19th century, and they had a bit of a water problem. As you can see, this is a hill, so everything is going down, and this is why they created those trenches to manage the flow of the water. And this is why the top areas of this woods is really dry and the lower sections are really wet. So this is the other firing range, and that's the one that was built I think in the 1950s. I'm not sure, don't quote me on it, but it's a presumably a Cold War era structure, and this was used for firing hand weapons. And here is a foundation of an old little building that I've seen on a photo and that does no longer exist. They have demolished this little house. Well, it was just a little office or something, I don't know what it was. And this is another thing. It's a concrete slab, with masonry below it. I think it's also a foundation of a former building. Oh, this part is also a bit wet. So that's the other firing range, and there are rumors that they used bricks from the old rolveld, you know, from the roads for the plains. The Germans used brick pavement, and a lot of that has disappeared. And in the 1950s or whenever they built this, they've just reused those bricks. There you have another view of the firing range that the Germans built. I think I'll just walk a bit on the side here, because this part is a lot drier. And this is essentially a similar structure, but it's smaller. And this one is in really good condition, as you can see. The masonry joints look really clean. There's not much erosion. The joinery on the bricks still looks rather well. Not much deterioration. The timber cladding looks still really good. Yeah, that still looks in rather good condition. And the top of the wall has a brick soldier course, and here at the back is a concrete roof slab. So let's get on top of this. And there's a bit of an earth wall to hide everything from view, because, well, right behind here is just a public forest. So this is the roof. And I think these are concrete beams that are clad with timber. So it's time for a few photos. So, and what we have here is the other side of the structure. And again, you can see quite a bit of nice detailing here. Oh, there is actually a little crack here in the wall. This bit is a bit cracked. But yeah, this is not calcium silicate, but regular fire brick. Although they say they thought these were pavement bricks, but I'm not really sure of that. It could be. But on the other hand, they could have also been new bricks. I'm not really certain on that. Oh yes, and that yellow round number plate there, that was the number of the building. Each building on the air base had a number. So there you have it. This was a bit of a look at an old firing range from fliegerhorst Twente. First we saw the German built structure over there, the big one, and then the later post-war era one that's hidden behind there, behind the bushes. So this bit of road is also paved. I think this pavement is from the 1950s. Not quite sure about that, but well, that was about it. I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching. See you again soon.